Hello everyone. So today, I will cover the concrete. You can see the face cover image. It is brought museum by the dealer's core video. It used the precast concrete module. Then we'll talk about this project later of this class. So we talk about different types of the concrete and how you can use this concrete material for your design. And then what kind of finish material, what kind of finish concrete material you might consider for your design. And they also talk about what is precast and post-tension concrete, what is different, and we just kind of talk about the different construction process and consideration through the lecture today. Before we discuss about the precast concrete, so we need to discuss about what is concrete. Okay, next image. So what is about concrete? So we have to be, you probably know about the concrete very well, right? This is a kind of pretty monolithic looking, and then very clean finish, but you need to be understanding about what is the actual meaning about the concrete. So this is a kind of my definition about the concrete. So I think about the concrete has the massive and monolithic quality, right? This is because of seamless kind of finish, and then it is looks like a more monolithic looking. And the concrete is strong in compression. The concrete will have a great tensile strength when it enhanced by steel reinforcement. Okay, and you can make in any shape or any form through the casting. Depending on the casting shape, you can design the various form. You also making the various surface texture, finish, and color depending on the pigment, depending on the finish material, and you can just making the any kind of texture and finish and colors. It is also various used in architecture field. You can use in a structural component as well as the cladding and paving finish. It is also can use in a fireproof. It is great fireproof resistant material. It's kind of great to proofing the some fire protection. So before we discuss about this precast type, we also need to talk about the basic concrete type first. So this is a typical concrete type you might consider in architecture industry. The concrete masonry unit, which is CMU, reinforced concrete, precast concrete, and the cast in place concrete. So we will cover the CMU next semester. I think mostly we talk about what is reinforced concrete, and what is the actual meaning about the precast concrete, and what is about the precast in place concrete. So we discuss about this issue through the lecture. And through this chapter, let's talk about the reinforced concrete. Means making the concrete stronger for structure member. How you making the concrete stronger? When you adding steel in your concrete, the concrete has the strength. The reinforced concrete is the combination of steel and concrete to give a more tensile strength. So when you adding the rebar, which is the metal inside, we call the rebar. So when you have the rebar inside the concrete gains tensile strength. In some court district like Iowa, the local code requires epoxy over the rebar. So means consider about the snow. When snow actually sitting over the surface, this is a change to the water, easy to change the water depending on the temperature. And then the water is easy to penetrating and into the rebar, and then affects the rebar strength. That's why in a cold district like Iowa, you have to be protect the rebar through the epoxy coating. Okay, it can be much better protection. Okay, the reinforced concrete has the two tensioning method. First one, precast, pre-stressed concrete. Second, post-tension concrete. You just understanding about what is meaning about the reinforced concrete. When you're adding the concrete and steel, you gain the extra strength. But you also need to be know how you're making out of this reinforced concrete. There's two option, pre-stressed concrete and second option, post-tension concrete. Okay, and then you can just adding the this steel type. You can using the steel cable, steel mesh, and reinforced rebar. Okay. So first we talk about pre-stressed concrete. What is about the pre-stressed concrete? So means tensioning the metal member before pouring the concrete. It means pre means before, right? So you can just kind of following the kind of a process. Step one, you just kind of place the high tension steel cable, okay? The strength from each side, and then your concrete is the poured and allowed to cured. So means after that you pour the concrete, okay, over the pre-stressed metal member. After that, you're just cutting out, at least some cable, just cutting out each side. So when cutting out the concrete cable, see, usually having that some deflection here. Because about the when just cable cutting out and then just kind of pushing this side, that's why concrete usually diffract this side. But you don't need to worry because when the beam is loaded, it becomes flat and transfer the stress to the concrete. So I mean you can simply locating over the some column or beam, it getting flat and gain the extra strength. Okay, so just understanding about the pre means before, so means you tensioning before pouring the concrete. Next one, you can even see the image how you can creating it. You can see the some concrete, but you can see the cable is pre-tensioning both side. Okay, so means simply just pour the concrete after gain the strength. You're cutting out the cable to gain the some strength of your concrete. So next type is post-tension concrete. So what is about the post-tension? Post means after, the pre means before. So means post-tension means after pouring the concrete, you will tensioning the cable after that. Okay? So just kind of see the process. So it is pre-stressing steel cable inside the plastic duct. You can see the cable locating in the plastic duct. After that, you pour the concrete. Okay? Then after gain the some strength, and then so each cable strength each side, okay, each side. So means the precast concrete, the concrete, the cable is pre-tensioning first and then pour the concrete. In this case, the release the cable inside and then pour the concrete and then tensioning after the gain the strength. So it means you can just kind of also having the, some diffraction like that. However, after loaded the beam or column, it becomes flat and gain the some strength. Okay, so you have to be understanding what is difference between pre-tension and post-tension concrete. Just simply understanding of the pre means before, post means after. So just kind of understanding also what is difference between. Okay. So now we talk about this. See the image here. So you can see this is a pre-stressed cable in the plastic duct, and then after curing the concrete. And simply tensioning both sides, okay, to gain the strength. So that's why called post-tension concrete. So you can see the image here, how it construct. You can see the difference in the compactor machine. You see the machine here, the tensioning after curing the concrete. So what we talk about the some more precast concrete type. The precast concrete is the construction product produced by casting concrete is reusable mold or form. Okay? So means precast means also pre means before casting. So precast concrete, it is everything made in the factory using the reusable mold or form. So means making out this form and reusable mold, pouring the concrete, making this concrete product in the factory, and after complete some this concrete product, it transport, and then it simply assemble in a field like a Lego. The Lego block is made in a factory, but it simply transport and then using this Lego block to making out some building or making out some the Lego product. So this is a similar process here. So means you can see the precast stair and the precast wall here. So everything made from the factory and deliver on the site and then assemble on the site. Okay. But what is about the different type? Cast in place concrete. What is about the cast in place concrete? You see the precast concrete? Is made by factory and delivered on the site. Okay, they have some process. However, the cast in place means cast in place in a field. So everything happening in the construction field. It is poured in the site specific form and cured on the site. Then it assembled in a field. It means every construction process in a field. Okay, casting concrete in a field and assemble in a field, everything happening in a construction site. So you can see the image here. You can cite the specific the wall. Oops, sorry. You can see the site specific wall. And then they actually put the some the guide wall for mold, and then placing the rebar inside for the reinforcing the concrete, and then you have to be pouring the concrete inside. So it means precast concrete, this piece is made from the factory, or cast place concrete, the made in a construction site. Okay? So you have to be understanding about what is about the precast mean, what is about the cast in place concrete mean, and then what is about the pretension mean, post-tension mean. Okay? You have to be understanding about this definition first before understanding about the next topic. Okay? Please study yourself, and then I just keep asking you guys coming to the lecture between the 2 and 3:30 if you have any question. Because you have to be understanding about this basic concept to adapt this concept to the actual design. Okay? This is a very basic terminology. Please remember about the term. Also, please remember about some concept for each individual thing. Okay? But if you have any question, please come to the lecture time and then please give a question to me. Okay? So then I just bring the very interesting cast in place concrete type. So this project named Truffle House, designed by Ensemble Studio, a space that sits on the ground and blend with the territory. It camouflage and integrate with the natural environment. So that's why it's called the truffle house. Truffle means like a black mushroom. This is mostly pretty hidden, located in the hidden space. So that's why he architect want to camouflage his building using the concrete. It's kind of very interesting because natural material and concrete material is very different, but how he camouflage this artificial material into the nature using the cast in place concrete method. So I think this is a really interesting project using the cast in place concrete method. So using the very different the construction process I can introduce later after this slide. So I think that is kind of a very compelling and intriguing kind of process. It means I just bring up this project because when you understanding about the basic concept of precast and cast in place concrete, post tension and pretension. You have to be understanding about the basic concept and basic technology method. Then you can easily adapt this method to your own thing. It means when you add your language over the cast in place concrete method, you're making out your own individual architecture. However, if you don't know about what is meaning about the cast in place concrete, you never making out these the unique language architecture, right? So it means you have to be understanding about the knowledge, and you have to be having own aesthetic manner, have to be combining together to making out your own individual design. So this is kind of what I thinking about the architecture, right? So that's why I bring this image here, this project image, because you can tweak your typical idea, you can make something different and interesting design or material. So let's look at this project more. So this project process and construction process very interesting. So you can just kind of find out. You can see image. So you can just kind of dig in the ground and then the placed hay bale, and then pour the concrete, and then the remove the concrete. Man, you can already getting the pretty interesting the texture you can get, and then. So you just can hay bale inside, but you need to make in a negative space. So that's why you invite Sam here, which is the small plant cow. he start eating the hay bale, and the cow's getting bigger and bigger, and he finish up the old hay bale, and then now you have a space, and you coming in, you eating the same, and now you're good to live, right? This is a kind of pre-poetic process, and then pre-abstraction process to making out the human space. So this is a make out the space here. Okay, so this is a kind of pretty amazing made by Hespel. So it means you can see the structure, you can see the some texture over it. But yeah, but I'm just kidding for eating the cow. But I don't know they, after they constructed this space, for cows stay in a safe place. Don't worry about it. Okay, but anyway, I bring it out the video. Okay, to show about how architect, which is the ensemble studio, they made this space. I think this video is very compelling. Please watch together, and then we can move in the next topic. Okay.
Thank you.
I hope you're just understanding about how you're making out, how you tweak the method to training this creative work. Okay? But now I'm just kind of comparing what is different between the precast concrete and cast in place concrete here. So we can see the what is about the some advantage and then what is about the disadvantage between the two different construction method. The precast concrete, the construction period is shorter because it is using a reusable mold and everything made in a factory. So mean it is much faster to creating the some product, and then the construction site is easy to assemble from the this prefabricated method. Also, during the winter time, the cast in place concrete is difficult to work because concrete is pretty sensitive from the temperature. So but precast concrete is easy to control the temperature. So that's why during the winter time, the precast concrete can the produced in the factory. So that's why the precast concrete is shorter the period compared to the cast in place concrete. Initial cost, the precast concrete is lower because they're using the reusable mold and foam. So it means easy to creating the foam is kind of that's why it makes up the lower the initial cost compared to the cast in place concrete. However, the maintenance fee, the precast concrete is higher compared to the cast in place concrete because the precast concrete is supposed to making the small component like a beam component, column component, cladding component. But cast in place you can make in the one continuous big the component. So means when you're just making a small component, what is about the issue? Means you have to be protect the joint. Component to the component usually having a gap. Component to the component usually having a gap. So means, do you remember about the through the gap? It has the lots of moisture transfer, lots of water penetrating. So that's why we talk about the damp protection from the previous lecture, which is lecture 2. When I talk about the underground condition, I talk about the damp propping. So please kind of watch this video again if you don't know about this protection. So if you have a small gap, but there's lots of water coming in, lots of moisture transfer. That's why we have to protect this joint. So it means you can use the sealant or spray paint over it. But this is another permanent method. You have to be maintaining this sealant joint or spray joint. Okay? That's why the precast is more the joint comparing to the cast in place concrete. That's why maintenance fee, the precast concrete is higher than cast in place concrete. And the concrete quality, of course, precast concrete is much better because it has the quality control in a factory. It cured it in a controlled environment. That's why the finish quality, concrete quality, precast concrete is better than cast in place concrete. Okay? Need to be understanding what is different between the two construction type, also understanding about this table too. Okay? So precast concrete mostly used in a structural beam or slab. It's mostly found from this conventional construction method. However, nowadays, architects choosing the precast concrete to develop their design because it is available to making the massive production with custom design. It's simply making the few the mold and they using this reusable mold to making this desired shape repeatedly. It means it can just reduce the cost. Also, it is have a control quality. So means it is kind of making this complex form from the precast method. This is a precast module. The module create various precast concrete form designed by fabricated from the CNC mold. So means making the some reusable mold by CNC milling machine. And then simply pour the concrete to create this panel here. After making the panel, of course, the left image testing out the mock-up test from the structure, the member, how structure member holding this cladding. After testing it out, and then it deliver on the site, construction site, and then construct and assemble over the structure. Okay, so it means every panel made from the factory and deliver on the site and simply assemble this construction. Constructed a precast concrete over the structure member. So this is a complete image you can see. Okay. So now we talk about the structural precast. So we're looking at the precast structure element first because it is the most common use in these days. So this is a typical structure type. you can see the typical the precast concrete slab. So you can see the left image solid flat slab, and the second image hollow core slab, and third double T, and fourth single T. You mostly find the double T and single T pretty easily in the factory or the hollow core slab as well. So let's talk about hollow core slab. You can see the hollow core slab, they have a hole, right? This is a void space inside. What is about the benefit when you have in the void inside of your concrete slab? You actually can reduce the weight as well as keeping the strength. Also, you can assess the some telephone data or some electricity and power lining conduit. So you can actually bring in this cable into this hole. So means you can actually reduce the weight. Also, you can recess this cable into the hole. And the next one is kind of a structural shape beam. What is about the benefit using this precast concrete beam? It provides unlimited flexibility in a design shape and application. So it means you can just depending on some form and mold, you can make in some any types of the form, any types of some design you can get. Also, it is extremely durable and strong product with no need for the extra fireproofing. And then the beam and column work well with the other precast component because you can see the image, you can see the extruded the rebar. So it means this is easy to connect the slab, or you can even have some column, you can easily take the column over it. Okay? So it means precast to the precast, easy to connecting together. And also, it is clean finish looking because it can control the quality from the factory. So you can see the precast concrete framing system. So you can simply precasting component and assemble this precast component in the construction site. So let's talk about the insulated precast concrete wall. What is about the insulated precast concrete wall? You remember about the concrete wall need to insulating the outside or inside. You need to use the pouring channel to adding the rigid insulation outside or inside and adding the finish wall. But this is a typical method, but they also making out this type, the sandwich panel, which is a concrete layer and another concrete layer and adding the rigid insulation between and sandwiching together to making out the single product. So mostly inside the layer or outside the layer, one side of layer of the concrete is structural member and the one layer is usually the cladding material. So you can just kind of see the character about this. This is a structurally efficient because one side of the concrete have to be structural member. And it is self-bearing and load-bearing because one side is always structural member. And then it's pre-finish one side or both sides. So means you can just kind of treat the finish looking outside and inside. So means you can just making some pre-finished the one side or both side. And then it is totally summer broken between outside and inside. You can see the rigid insulation. It's continuous rigid insulation here. So it means you can separating outside and inside through this layer. Okay. So means it is kind of really good at the thermal the protection. Okay. Thermal transfer protection. However, this product mostly found from the like Walmart or Target, like this kind of a big commercial the project because it's pretty difficult to make in the curved wall. It's mostly using the pretty rigid kind of a static wall. So that's why it's most popular to using this product in the mall or some big commercial building. Okay, but have a lot of benefit to using it still. So I just gonna bring the one more video how the factory the fabricating this sandwich panel so you better to understanding about the process to construction. Okay, let's watch together and then we talk about the next topic.
Precast concrete walls have a tough exterior that holds up to all kinds of weather. But making these structural wall panels is an inside job. Production starts with a mix of crushed rock and sand. This collection is limestone based. The mineral mix can be altered for different strengths and finishes. A conveyor delivers the collection of minerals to a huge mixer. Beaters whip the ingredients into a thick, gritty mix. Before they cast the wall, a crew arranges giant foam letters to make an imprint in the mold. A release agent is sprayed onto the casting form and letters. High-strength steel cables are strung throughout the form. With a hydraulic device, they pull each cable to a specific tension. Then they bend a rebar rod into a loop. The rebar loops are linked, creating long cages. They place one cage at the top of the form and one at the bottom. Then a team inserts a sheet of welded wire mesh. It's been cut to fit the size of the form. They're now ready to pour concrete. A truck dispenses the concrete directly into the form. The concrete flows around the steel reinforcement. The steel will keep the wall strong when the concrete expands and contracts as the weather changes. The team spreads the concrete and levels it with a tool called a screed. This first layer of the wall panel is essentially one side of a sandwich. It will be the exterior part of the wall. At the center of the sandwich is this rigid foam insulation. It's studded with protrusions to secure it to the concrete. More steel-reinforced concrete completes the wall sandwich. After about 12 hours, the wall is solid enough to be handled. They take it outdoors where a worker sandblasts a small section of the exterior side. This removes the surface cement to expose the aggregate, creating a decorative band next to the embossed lettering. After a 3-day cure, the precast concrete wall is ready for the construction site. The concrete continues to cure over time, so these precast walls will stand strong for many years.